got dogs that continually forge on their leash doing the heel command after they've graduated the full service training. So first thing I want to discuss is normally when people come back for the refresher classes, they'll tell us that their prong collars are too tight or they'll ask for more links. I know right then and there that people are having a confusion about where exactly the prong collar should fit. So the prong collar should not fit like the dog's normal buckle collar. So you see how the buckle collar hangs down lower on the neck? Even this prong collar right here is not fitted correctly. The prong collar needs to sit as high up on the neck as you can get it, and it needs to be snug to the skin so that when you give a correction, the prongs engage and actually pinch the top of the neck. So the concept is, the psychology behind the collar is it gives an equal pinch around the dog's neck, the same concept of when the moms give a correction to the puppies in the litter. So it needs to be high up on the neck, and you need to make sure that you can fit maybe just your hand underneath, but you do not want the prong collar to be baggy and to be hanging down. If you're in between sizes, they have different gauges of prongs that you could get. So if you feel like your prong collar is constantly slipping down the dog's neck, then maybe get a smaller gauge of the prong. So that's step number one. Step number two is you need to decide where it's acceptable for the dog to be in position. So for example, Max, good boy, sit. My boundary line, and when the dogs graduate the full service training, the boundary line that we create for the dogs is their leg and my leg are parallel. So imagine there's an invisible line right here that if the dog crosses it, you no longer can proceed forward because we do not want to give the dog a sense of progression if they are not in the position that is acceptable for us for healing. So it's very important that you decide where it's okay for your dog to be. If you're okay with your dog healing like this, okay, that's your boundary you create. Some people want the dog a little bit more behind. Me and Sam's requirement is right here, parallel dog's chest to my knee. So starting off, I'm gonna tell him to heel, and I'm just gonna start walking a little pattern. So Max, heel. If he crosses my boundary line, I'm gonna say no. No, correction, heel. Another thing I can do is I can also reward him in the position that I want him. Because then what you end up doing is just rewarding an automatic sit. So you'll have a dog that will forge, but then when you stop, they'll get back in the right position. So nothing is wrong with rewarding them while you're walking. Max, heel. Treats are a magnet to the dog, and the dog will start to wrap to try to catch my treat. I'm giving the dog the treat exactly where I want the dog. Now, if he goes wide, the correction would be back into me. So the direction of your correction is very important. If the dog is in front of us, the correction is going to be back. If the dog is wide, the correction is going to be into me. And if the dog is behind us, the correction is going to be forward. So the direction of the correction is very important to give the dog the information so that he can learn where exactly is acceptable. Another thing that's important is the dog should be able to change pace if you're changing pace. So Max, heel.